go to Jason Carroll.
Has Jason ever had potato latkes?
Of Pig Trail Nation. I don't know, but I was thinking about the idea of this two-man bicycle.
Yes.
I would love to see a tandem bicycle combination of SmackDown, Matty T, and Jason Carroll. So, Jason, if you were on that three-man tandem bike, I'm assuming you would want to be on the front seat, correct?
Probably. I mean, well, would we go anywhere?
Well, who's on the rear? Because that's going to be the better question. If I'm on the rear, Jason's going to be doing a lot of pedaling trying to get this thing moving.
Well, I got the leg strength to do it. I don't know.
Yes, sir. Either, though. There you go.
I mean, yeah. Am I eligible to win that bike? Then Phil and I can go on bike rides on the trails.
Jason always wants to know if he's eligible for these things. Well, no, we're not. We never pay you here from ESPN Arkansas, hey, Jason. So yeah, maybe you are.
Yeah, I don't know.
Hitthatline.com. You know where to go.
There's only one way you can enter, and then if you do win, we'll just leave it up to.
I don't want to take it from a person that deserves it. So, you know.
I would love to be riding next to you, Jason. So let me get you in on this conversation we've had the last couple of segments involving the quarterback situation for next year. Because I don't think Felipe Franks comes back. Do you see him coming back for a second year under any circumstance? And what circumstance would that be?
I give it less than 5% chance, and it would just be his feedback would not be of that, which would lead to him being a guy that's going to get drafted. And you know, I've said it on the show before. I think he's going to be anywhere from a fifth to seventh round draft pick, maybe higher. But you just never know. I mean, he's had such a good season in the abbreviated season so far, and you look at where he's going to rank in the history of just seasons at Arkansas, I don't see him coming back. So that leads you to believe you're going to need to get a grad transfer because you're going to have these red shirts or these true freshmen coming in. And I don't know if KJ is going to be here next year or not, but he's the only one that's got experience. I mean – you know, Malik Hornsby's got those two rushes, and that's it. And so they're going to be in a bad spot at quarterback next year, whatever happens, unless they were to bring in another grad transfer type quarterback, which could happen.
Well, that's exactly what I see happening, and I think it has to happen, to be honest. Not even for the idea that grad transfer has to be the starter, but I would just feel so much better. Let's say that it is Malik Hornsby that's the starting quarterback next year. I would feel so much better knowing that Malik has beaten out a veteran, experienced college quarterback than just beating out a couple of true freshmen. And if KJ is still around, you know, a guy that's played a game in a series. So I think that Arkansas, if Franks doesn't come back, and I don't think it matters. I don't think it does affect recruiting quarterbacks at all. I think what it just does is stabilize the team for next year, which should lead to being able to bring in some quarterbacks because you got a program that's winning games. I think they have to have a veteran quarterback next year. That's at the top of the list of needs.
Yeah, I just don't know if they can bring one in or not. Their numbers are pretty tight right now, so if they're going to do it, they're going to have to figure that out pretty quick because they've got two quarterbacks committed. High school guys, signing days, you know, a couple weeks away. I don't know what the situation is going to be for them scholarship-wise to do that. Now, I'm not saying they won't get it done if that's what they need. At some point, though, you've got to get these guys experience playing or you're going to keep recycling and doing the same thing over and over again where you're never going to have guys that you actually recruit ever play for you. So you might have to bite the bullet next year and just go out with one of those, whether it's KJ Jefferson, Malik Hornsby, or these two freshmen they're bringing in, and just play them and see what you get. And maybe lightning strikes with one of those four guys and you move on and kind of build that program around that person that you might have for 3 or 4 years instead of trying to hit lightning in a bottle. I mean, because you look at what they did last year, they tried to hit lightning in a bottle and it blew up in their face with those two guys. So maybe they just play the guys that they have coming in and see what happens.
Jason Carroll, the Pig Trail Nation, here with us on Halftime. Jason, just got a couple things for you before we wrap it up. Looking ahead to this Arkansas-Missouri game, where's your thought process right now with this football game? I think me and Phil kind of both agree that with the talent coming back that's been either quarantined, have been positive, whatever it is, with the talent coming back, I think Arkansas should be in good shape. But, Jason, this ain't a Missouri team defensively that you can't take lightly heading into this ball game.
No, it's not. I'm more concerned about stopping Roundtree in the running game. You know, they got the young quarterback who's made some plays this year, but I think you can make him make some mistakes like you've made some of the other guys make mistakes. I'm just more worried about them being able to stop the run and contain that. I mean, they do have a good defense, but you look at who they played the last couple of weeks, it hasn't been world beaters offensively in Vanderbilt and in South Carolina. So, you know, while they've done those positive things the last 2 weeks defensively, talking about Missouri, I don't think it's been against an offense like Arkansas. So I think Arkansas will be fine offensively. It's can they stop Missouri's running game? Because Roundtree's killed them in the past, and Roundtree's their best option back there, and you just hope that you don't allow those big runs, big scoring plays from him. Because I think Arkansas will win this game probably by 10 points or more, or should win this game by 10 points or more and get their fourth win.
I want to transition over to the hardwood real quick. I mean, Arkansas is two games in the men's basketball side of when you look at it. And obviously we weren't on, we had best of shows playing, so we didn't get to talk about the 80-point victory against Mississippi Valley State. And then you transition that into a 14-point victory against North Texas. But the thing that's kind of glaring to me, we tipped off the show with this, Jason, where Arkansas played nearly every guy against Mississippi Valley State, and you saw a lot of the freshmen, a lot of the guys got pretty good equal playing time. North Texas, only eight guys played, and you didn't. Vance Jackson only played 8 minutes of the game. Kalen Robinson only played 5 minutes, and you didn't see Jalen Williams. You didn't see Devontae Davis. Is that concerning, or is this just Musselman trying to figure out kind of like what these players got and just kind of tinkering with the lineup and seeing what works and what doesn't?
It's probably matchups for him right now, and he felt like those guys were the best matchups because, again, I've said this, and I'm not going to tell him how to do his job, but Jalen Williams and Devontae Davis sitting on the bench not playing a minute is not a good look for your future recruiting in the state of Arkansas. And, you know, those two guys need to be playing. And I'm not saying you play them a lot if you don't have to, but you don't want four stars from the state of Arkansas sitting on the bench, especially in an early season game like that, because that transitions down to that 2022 class where they've got to go out and get those guys. And if guys start seeing that, if that's a trend later on down the line as we move through this non-conference thing, you know, people are going to start looking at that. If you're a 2022 or beyond kid, then there's a lot of talent. That's just my viewpoint there on that. But for him, I'm sure it was about matchups, and Connor Vanover played a lot more because he felt like that he could control the inside a little bit better. They finally got to Connor last 5-6 minutes of the game and figured out how to play him and get around him. But yeah, Vance got to play more, and I think those younger guys got to play. That's why you brought them in. They were top five class. They're not going to sit the bench, or they're not going to be here after this year. So,
Jason, we'll leave it there. We're going to be up against the break here. Any chance I get your loveliness in person with me Monday next week, or do we have to have you on the phone again? I miss you.
Just pray that my kid's not virtual again next week, and then you can have me every Monday.
Yeah, baby. Yeah.
Well, it's more than I got. I need you. I need you, Jay.
I played teacher today for the first time. That was, you know.
Professor Carroll. All right, Jason.
Well, we got the work done. Talk to you guys later.
Good. Thanks, all right, well,
Jason.
Thanks for coming on, as always.